Next, I'll be speaking with the three candidates vying for House District 22, covering the areas around Kincaid, Jewel Lake, and Sand Lake. A reminder that each candidate will have her or his opening remarks, then questions from me, before getting the chance to ask questions of one another ahead of closing remarks. Here with me, in alphabetical order, is independent candidate Dustin Darden, non-affiliated candidate Jason Grenn, and the incumbent Republican Liz Vazquez. And Mr. Darden, let's start with your opening remarks.
Thanks for tuning in tonight. My name's Dustin Darden. I'm running for State House District 22 to represent Alaska. We're living in a pivotal time in American history, and this election is extremely important. I stand for constitutional values. I stand for what's right, and I'm going to do what I can to keep America on track in regards to the state of Alaska specifically. I'm also working on cleaning up our water supply. We currently import our fluoride. 200 pounds of fluoride is added to the cleanest water in the nation every day to the Anchorage water supply. That's a 50-pound bag of industrial toxic waste being dumped into our water every 6 hours. So me and the clean water team, Anchorage.com, are working on cleaning it up. So check out the website, and thanks for tuning in.
Thank you, Mr. Darden. And Mr. Grenn, we'll go to you.
Hi. Hello, my name is Jason Grenn. I'm the independent candidate running in District 22. And along with my wife and three children, I'm proud to be raising a family in the same neighborhood I grew up in and running for State House. I'm running for one simple reason. I still believe that Alaska's best days are ahead of us. And if we work together and find solutions creatively, we can have great parks, great businesses, and great schools. But we need leaders who are accessible, accountable, and willing to make the hard choices. I'm inspired by all the neighbors that I meet going door to door. And they tell me one thing: Alaska can be an incredible place to raise a family, to work, and to have a great time. Thank you.
All right, and thank you. And Representative Vazquez, your opening remarks.
Well, thank you. It's been an honor and a pleasure to represent District 22. And I have a wide range of public experience. I've been a commissioner on several commissions, including the School Budget Advisory Commission on the city level, the Anchorage Equal Rights Commission, and the Anchorage Budget Advisory Commission. I've been an administrative law judge, an assistant attorney general, and a prosecutor. I am definitely interested in public service. As a freshman, I've only served, it'll be 2 years in January, I actually did put in the hopper 13 bills, two of them were passed, and all to make healthcare more accountable and more accessible to people. I'm passionate about eliminating waste inefficiency before we get into people's wallet.
Okay, thank you. So the first question that I want to ask all of you is one that I imagine you're hearing a lot from voters. We'll begin by asking, what is your plan for closing the state's multi-billion dollar deficit? And Mr. Darden, we'll start with you.
Well, there's a lot of things you can do. You can use attrition for positions that are being manned right now, and there's a lot of programs that I believe we could cut. And honestly, I think we could save a lot of money by not giving free hot meals and warm beds and these very luxurious facilities we call prisons and jails to horrific crime offenders. I think we should model after the, is either Nevada or the lower 48 state, where they put people in tents and put them outside to where they don't want to go back to prison. So I'm zero tolerance on sexual offense in Alaska. We got to nip that in the bud, and we need to nip the nasty crimes out of Alaska and treat criminals in such a way they don't want to do crime anymore.
Okay, and Mr. Grenn, the budget gap to you.
Sure. I think there's a comprehensive plan that needs to be in place, and I think that's something that Republicans and Democrats both agree on. I think it starts with obviously more cuts and reforms. There's ways that we can eliminate waste and make government more efficient, but I think we also need to look at using the permanent fund in a restructuring or some sort of cap to start using that for government services. Those things combined with some small increases to some industries and in taxes, I think we'll start to close the gap significantly enough that we can use our resources and our savings for the next several years in order to create a great comprehensive plan.
Okay, and Representative Vazquez, a question to you.
Well, there's a lot of things we need to be doing, continuing our cuts. We cut about $200 million this year. We will need to continue to make wise cuts, go in with a scalpel, cut out the waste and inefficiencies. We need to look at diversification of the economy. We need to look at, we have a pipeline. How do we put more oil in the pipeline? Use some of the earnings reserve. It is not the corpus of the permanent fund, but the earnings reserve was envisioned to be used to make up the difference down the road. So there's lots of things we need to be doing all at once, unfortunately.
Okay, we'll move on to the chance for you to each ask a question of one of your challengers. And so, Mr. Darden, we'll start with a question to either one of your the other candidates.
Okay. Yeah, one thing I was wondering, and it's a pretty important issue to me, I was wondering, Liz, how do you support Alaska Right to Life, the organization Alaska Right to Life, and their efforts?
Well, I'm basically a supporter of Right to Life. I'm not sure that I would support their total vision of Right to Life. They seem to have a draconian program and insist that everybody enlists on that draconian program. And I don't necessarily agree with that draconian vision. I do think that we need to have more education about the development of a fetus, which wasn't available during the Roe and Wade decision. And we need to make adoptions a lot more accessible and affordable, by the way. They're very expensive right now. So.
Okay, and a rebuttal from you, Mr. Darden.
Yeah, I met Christopher Kirka and his wife and this family when I was working on the Joe Miller campaign about, was it 4 years ago? And these people, when I walked into that room and I saw the volunteers, Christopher Kirka, he's the manager for Alaska Right to Life, I was just blown away by their dedication and their family-oriented way of thinking. And, that's one of the things that sparked my interest in getting into politics was volunteering for the Joe Miller campaign and Alaska Right to Life. And one thing I've discovered is that in regards to fluoride, the fluoride actually goes through the fetus. It goes through the placenta into the developing baby. So it's something that also segues into this issue.
Okay, and so Mr. Grenn, your opportunity to ask a question of a challenger.
Thank you. I'd like to ask Representative Vazquez, even though the Republican Party is still supporting Donald Trump, some of your colleagues, including Senator Murkowski and Senator Sullivan, have dropped their support. And I'd like to know who you plan on voting for president.
Frankly, I'm very busy with my own campaign and keeping up with my office duties. So that's something I'm really not concerned. I'm concerned about my district. I'm concerned about the welfare of the state and my people in my district. And that's more important than what's going on a national basis. Frankly, I can affect what's going on a national basis.
Mr. Grenn, your rebuttal.
Sure. I'd like to let people know right now at the moment I plan on voting for Gary Johnson. For me, I have major concerns on both parties in terms of their candidacy, in terms of what they bring to a national level, but also what they see for Alaska's future. And I think that, who we decide for president will have a great impact on Alaska. And I think it's a very serious issue that we should be discussing and know who our elected leaders choose to vote for.
Very good. Thank you all. A question I'd like to ask now is that the last legislature was taken to task for not doing its job within the 90 days allotted and went into its special session. I'm curious, if elected, how each of you would govern more expediently and effectively. And we'll begin with Mr. Grenn.
One of the things I have planned is to eliminate per diems after that 90 days. I think that penalties that legislators need to know that Alaska takes serious, that there's penalties if they don't do their job on time. For the past 2 years, the legislature failed to pass a budget which is constitutionally mandated, and I think that's hurting Alaskans in terms of knowing what's coming up down the economic pipe. If there's taxes or cuts, they need to know ahead of time. And instead of kicking the can down the road, I think we need to let legislators know that there's penalties for if they don't do their job on time.
Okay, and Ms. Vazquez has a question to you.
Well, the governor kept calling the legislature into session. He threw at us over 9 taxes, major. For example, he wanted to double the taxes on aviation fuel. There was no economic analysis, no economic modeling for these taxes. The usual response we would get from his commissioners and deputy commissioners was that we had a fiscal gap, and therefore these taxes would help. Well, I think it's irresponsible to make a decision on taxes unless you have good economic analysis and good modeling. And I would consider some of these taxes, but I also would insist on cutting waste and inefficiencies.
Okay, thank you. And Mr. Darden, the question to you on governing more effectively and efficiently.
Well, specifically to expedite the process when the legislature is in session, what you can do is you can go vote. When you vote for an individual, look for someone who you think is actually going to go in there and accomplish working across the aisle to get the ultimate betterment for the state of Alaska, for your section of America. And another thing you can do is you can actually change the Alaska state constitution. If you don't feel like the sessions are being adequately applied, then you as the people can go in and say, hey, you guys have 1 week to get this done. If you don't get it done, then you're done. So the people need to vote and they need to be educated.
Thank you. We have to circle back. I'm afraid I made a mistake, and Representative Vazquez, I forgot to ask you or offer you the opportunity to ask a question of your challengers. It's my mistake, but if you'd like to use this time now to ask for one of them and then have a chance for a rebuttal.
So do I get to choose whoever first? Okay. Dustin Darden, hi.
Hi.
Well, what would be your major goal once you were elected to the legislature?
My major goal would be to better Alaska, to put Alaska first, to put America first, and to just do what the people want to do. When we go down to session, get a budget written up, get it done, cut waste. I want to keep taxes low. I want to ultimately prevent additional income or sales tax on the state level. I want to support our local municipalities to not impose sales tax that the far left is actually planning on doing right now, I believe. And I want to get fluoride out of the state of Alaska. I want to be the first state in the nation to have a fluoride-free state.
Okay, and so your rebuttal, Representative Vazquez.
I have no rebuttal. I mean, it's you're making general statements, and that's good. I mean, it's often quite complicated when you get down to Juneau, working with 39 other people, so.
Okay, we have run out of time for me to ask questions of each of you, so now you'll have an opportunity to offer your closing remarks, again in alphabetical order. So Mr. Darden, we will start with you.
Excuse me, I didn't get to ask Mr. Grenn a question.
The opportunity was only to ask a question of one challenger, not both of them.
I misunderstood.
So it was the same option afforded to both of them, and we'll go to closing statements now, Mr. Darden.
Thank you. Thanks for tuning in once again. Don't forget to vote on the 8th coming up. On April 4th, vote yes for clean water. We're working on an initiative this spring that will eliminate fluoride until they can prove what's in it, if it's safe for human consumption, and that it's clean. And right now it's not. It's imported from China. It's really nasty, nasty stuff. I'm supporting Donald J. Trump. I have no shame in that. We have to keep America armed. Hillary Clinton wants to disarm the nation. I adhere to constitutional amendments, and by all means, I'm going to support these things. If you think that it's okay for Mexicans to come into America, I encourage you to go to Canada without their permission and
Sir,
get a job.
You are running out of time. Thank you. We're going to move on. Mr. Grenn, your closing remarks.
Thank you. My extensive background in nonprofits and volunteering throughout our community has taught me that sometimes solutions need creative thinking and finding ways to do more with less. And if elected to Juneau, you can count on me to do such things. Working with Republicans, working with Democrats, working with anyone who's willing to put together a comprehensive fiscal plan. Alaska is in a very critical state right now. And I think, talking to the 5,000 neighbors in our district, they want us to please put aside politics and do what's best for Alaska. If you vote for me on November 8th, you can count on that. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. And Representative Vazquez, the closing remarks and the closing segment goes to you.
Yes, and I'm asking for people's vote on November 8th. I've worked very hard during the past 2 years. I have introduced 13 bills in order to make state government more efficient. While I believe we do need a comprehensive fiscal plan, the governor's fiscal plan means equates to more taxes. It really isn't fiscally responsible. It doesn't address major inefficiencies. For instance, we have 54 school districts for only 128,000 students. Six of those school districts have less than 100. So we need to look at ways of making government more accountable, more transparent, more efficient, less waste, before we ask people to step up and give half of their PFD or get income tax.
Okay, thank you very much. That was all three candidates running for House District 22 in West Anchorage, Alaska Independence Party member Dustin Darden, non-affiliated candidate Jason Grenn, and Republican Liz Vazquez, who currently holds the seat.